Hey guys, it's megane-tapir back at it again with another video. And by the time you're watching this video, I will be at Anna Minneapolis, and you guessed it, Minneapolis. So I decided for this video, I'd do a little talk about how, like, not to be that kid at anime conventions, you know, the one that everybody hates and the one that everyone thinks is annoying. So, yeah. Because, like, there aren't enough videos about how not to be annoying at anime conventions. Like, there are a shit ton. But hey, you know, let's beat this dead horse until it stops getting views. So, let's get into it, fam. Everyone at a con is there to have fun, just to have a good time, just kind of chill. But you gotta realize there are still rules you need to follow. Not just the one that the con staff says is the rules, but, like, basic courtesy stuff as well. Like, don't freak out when you see someone cosplaying your favorite character or a character you really like. They're doing what they love, and underneath that wig, they are just a person like you and I. I know it's hard to look at a person and see someone other than their character, but oftentimes I don't really know their names. I will refer to someone in our panel as, like, our Yorio or our Hanji, but it's not because I see them as the character. I see them as a person, and I just don't know their names. I never really use their character names to get their attention, or if I'm talking to them anytime before or after our panel, I just use them if I'm talking about them to somebody else who is not them. Okay, so now let's go into a hypothetical, cool? Let's say it's your first convention ever, and you really like Sword Art Online for some reason, and Kirito is your all-time favorite boy. If you see someone cosplaying as Kirito, your first instinct may be to yell, "Oh, hey, Kirito," and say, "Oh my god, I love you." This is a no-no. It's a big ol' no-no. That cosplayer is probably gonna be, like, super weirded out, as, you know, cosplayers don't follow the same rules as the, like, face characters at Disney parks do. While, like, a princess at Disney will stay in character at all times on her duty, cosplayers don't really do that, unless the person in question is, like, a really young child and they want to keep that sort of magic alive. Instead of freaking out and confessing your love to someone you've never even seen before based on their cosplay, maybe just ask to take a picture with them or, or, like, of them, and ask for their Instagram so you can tag them and possibly get to know them better than, you know, just Kirito. Instead of saying, "Oh my god, I love you," try saying, "Oh my god, I love your cosplay," as cosplayers often make their own costumes and therefore take immense pride in their work. Even if they don't make their own costumes, it is so nice to hear someone say that they like your cosplay and that you look great in it. Now let's talk about behavior when you're, say, walking around in groups with your friends who are also cosplaying the same thing as you. Just, you know, treat it like you're at a mall and talking casually with your friends. Being disruptive is, like, never appreciated. It's not cute, it's not funny, it's annoying to literally everyone else. Last day in Minneapolis, there was this big group of Voltron cosplayers doing their "When I say Vol, you say Tron" chant as they, like, walked around together. And it was just so annoying. You could tell everyone else besides that group of people were so infuriated by these people just yelling their stupid Voltron chant while they were all just having their own conversations and trying to have a good time. You gotta realize that this is a public space. The convention center is a public space. Everyone there is there for a reason, and if the convention is at a hotel, there are people staying at that hotel who are not attending the convention, so you need to be respectful to them, too. You know those people who, like, don't know a convention is going on and don't even know what a convention is? You don't want to weird them out and, like, scare them and scar them forever, because I have seen that happen, and it's never been good. Don't get me wrong, though. Like, I'm super pumped that you're all having such a great time, but it's super disruptive to everyone. Save your screaming for raves or room parties. Along with the idea of respecting your fellow congoers, respect people selling things in the artist alley and the dealer's room. Artists really like it when you ask them about their days or what programs they use to make their work. They're sitting there in a small booth in a very little space with very little breaks, if any, for hours on end, and a friendly face or just a, gosh, this style is so cute, really helps make their days feel just a little bit better and makes them feel a little bit more appreciated. Like last year at DaishoCon, there was this artist whose booth was like super cute and super pastel, so I was like, oh my god, your booth is so cute, and she's like, oh my god, thanks. And then I looked through some of her art and I was like, oh my god, this is also adorable. And she started telling me about like one of her OCs that was having a print being sold of that character, and I was like, oh my god, that's great, I love him. So, and she just seemed so happy and so content that someone was actually, you know, caring enough to listen to her and just kind of compliment her art, ask her how her day was going, ask her if she'd been up to anything fun, ask her if she wanted, like, food or anything. She just seemed so happy and so ecstatic to see someone actually, like, caring about her as a person and not just like an art machine. She didn't have business cards, but some people at conventions do. They do have business cards, be they cosplayers, artists, or hell, even photographers. You know, go ahead and take them. They're there for a reason. Artists and cosplayers typically have pictures of their work on the card, as well as like all their social media, so you can follow them, check them out, keep up to date with what they're doing, what cons they're going to, all that good stuff. And photographers and artists often have, say, email addresses and contact information, so, as well. So, if you want to, say, commission someone, or if you like their work, you know, take a card. I have a lot of business cards from cons, mostly from artists, but there are a lot of good cosplay photographers lurking around there at conventions too, so like, if you see one that you like, jump on that, man. If you're in the market for some professional shots of your cosplay at like a specific location, a lot of like photographers who go to conventions are totally down for that. They'll give you a business card and you can like set up a time to meet and, you know, get some professional photos taken of your cosplay, and then the photographer will edit the picture to make it look as good as possible, and then it will give it to you, which is something really fantastic. And having a card to, like, remember that, just in case, really comes in handy. I have a little tin in my room, just, like, full of business cards in case I ever want to, like, commission an artist, ask them a question, or just kind of, like, see their updated work, an updated look at their portfolio, and that's totally okay. Just, like, respect the artists and the artistry that goes behind everything these people are doing. I know it doesn't seem too hard to, oh, take a pretty picture, but even photographers do a lot of editing, and they're just there to help you get that perfect shot. So, in the end, to, you know, not be that kid at anime conventions, just, you know, don't be an asshole and think about other people's feelings as well as your own. Make sure everyone around you is comfortable, or, you know, to the best of your abilities, if you can, you know, help them not be so agitated, you know, tone it down, maybe help people out by, you know, asking them how their day is, offering to get them water. It's fine. Just don't be an asshole, be courteous, be considerate to everybody else. But, yeah, that's all for this time. If you wanna say, like, some weird things that you've seen people do at conventions that you found really disrespectful, go ahead and put that in the comments below. But until next time, bye!